Let's learn a new chapter from your class 2nd EVS textbook. Lesson number 4, We Are For You. In this module, you're going to learn about the coconut and banana tree and its uses, the different types of flowers, about grains, vegetables and fruits, about medicinal plants, and also why do animals need plants. So let's begin our today's class. Observe the picture, students. Looking at the picture, you can guess the tree, right? My fruit is very tasty. My tender water so sweet. Dry leaves can light a fire. The sticks of leaves make a broom. My husk can make a mat and the rest can make a rope. Now I hope you guessed the answer. Which tree is this? Yes, it's a coconut tree. Now let's learn what does the coconut tree give. It gives us coconut fruit which we use in the preparation of curry. In Kannada, we say kaituri, right? We use tender coconut water to drink. Bonda juice, like, right? We get coconut oil out of it. We use coconut oil for our hair. We get coconut husk out of which we can produce ropes. Now let's learn some more points about coconut tree. People use its leaves to prepare roofs for their small huts. Coconut leaves have thick sticks which are used to make brooms. The coconut flowers are used in preparation of medicines because it has medicinal value. Coconut husk, shells, leaves, flower, stems are used to lit the fire. Now next we'll learn about one more plant. So name the plant. I think you guessed the answer. Tasty, tasty fruit. The raw is cooked. Leaves used for meals and fiber for clothes. Who am I? Yes, it's a banana plant. Now let's learn what are the advantages of banana plant. We can eat sweet bananas. Some of you might like bananas, right? We can even eat their stem. It has medicinal value. We use banana plant fibers to make garments. Garment means clothes. In cloth factories, we use banana plant fibers to make clothes. Banana leaves are used to pack food. At home, sometimes your moms might be using banana leaves, right, to pack food. It is used as natural leaf platters. During festival season, we make banana leaf as plate, right? And we have lunch, meal or dinner in that leaf. It also has medicinal value. Next, we'll learn about grains, vegetables and fruits. First, we'll learn about grains. Rice, dal, wheat, ragi, oats, millet, corn. These are some examples for grains. Vegetables. Greens, beans, carrot, beetroot, pumpkin, tomato, cucumber. These are some examples for vegetables. Next we'll see about fruits. Mango, banana, grapes, orange, apple, pear, watermelon and strawberries. Now these grains, vegetables and fruits we use in our daily meal because it gives us strength. It has vitamins, minerals which increase our immune system, which also gives our body strength. Next we'll learn about flowers. So you might be having flower garden at your house, right? In that garden we are growing hibiscus, sunflower, lily, rose, daisy, dahlia. These are some of the flower plants which we grow in our house. Next we'll learn about plants that we use for medicinal purpose. First is tulsi. Tulsi can cure fever. Their leaves are used to treat skin problems like pimples, acne, etc. Tulsi is used to treat insect bites. Next plant is mint. Mint is rich with nutrients. It improves our digestive system and also improves brain function. Next is lemon. You like lemon juice, right? So this lemon also has medicinal value. Lemon is rich with vitamin C. Lemon is used to treat cold and also flu. It also used to treat kidney stones. Next is neem plant. It is used to cure fever. It is also used to treat diabetics and liver problems. Next we'll learn, why do animals need plants? They need oxygen to breathe, which comes from plants. Like animals, human beings, insects, we depend on plants because plants produce oxygen. They depend on plants for their food. Herbivores are animals that eat only plants. Because some animals, they eat only plants. They don't eat any other animals, such as cow, horse, deer, goat, sheep, etc.